That's nice. This is what I've been waiting for this entire trip. Since we didn't have a long drive or a ridiculous sight induction or whatever it is that's kept us from getting the really crispy sunrise shots, I think we're gonna finally get them today. The purpose of this project, it's a dam.
It's essentially, you know, a circle, and in the middle, this is built up 8 meters, so I'm gonna build it.
At the front, we built a really big entrance.
So here is the dam right here. It's basically this ring with this open area in between. This open area is where they're cutting right now, so they have essentially scrapers running here, and they're placing the material up here. This entire area needs to be cut. I think it's 400 millimeters and recompacted across. So this entire area is cut, the topsoil is stripped, it's over excavated, it's recompacted, and it's essentially level across the entirety of this area. The purpose of this project is for water storage. So this water, they'll pump the water in here to fill this entire area. And then as farmers need it from around here, they can get it almost immediately on demand. Right now, it takes about 7 days for the water to reach these farms in this area. So the farmers will order the water 7 days ahead before they need it. Now, with this project, the water district or whoever the customer is can fill this, and then as the farmers need it, distribute that water within a day, making everything around here grow more effectively and make the water be used a lot more effectively as well. So this is really, really essential work, not just for the farmers, but for the people that eat the food that they grow, the oranges, the rice, everything around here that's grown and distributed around Australia. Since this is for water storage, this entire structure is very well engineered. Here's an example of the engineering right behind me is this drain. As they build the structure of the dam, they come back through here with this really skinny trenching bucket. I haven't seen one quite like this before. And they dig a trench that's then backfilled with sand. So the water is gonna be on that side. And if the water does permeate the dam, get through this clay that they're filling in here, building the dam with, it'll hit the sand, it'll drain to the bottom to hit the sand layer on the very bottom that they're building the dam upon, and will drain out away from the dam without impacting the integrity of the actual structure and causing a catastrophic failure. You don't want a dam to fail. There's a lot of water that's gonna be in here. If that water gets into anywhere else, like that rail line right there, or that highway on the other side, or fields, or floods people's homes down the way, that's a huge problem. So this drain right here is one of those key features that maintains the integrity of this structure. Even if water can permeate it, it'll just hit this and drain out in an organized fashion. Make sure he's right on the money. He's running TopCon, so he's watching GPS to get right in the middle of the dam, exactly where that trench needs to be. That trenching bucket's pretty wacky.
What they'll do with the GPS is they'll measure that bucket to determine, based on that machine and the sensors and the GPS receivers, where exactly the edge of the bucket is. They'll program that into the computer. So when he gets that bucket, he hits that bucket within the computer, so then that GPS knows exactly where that edge of the bucket is. That's how you can hook up different buckets to the GPS unit. Every bucket's measured, and all it is geometry determining exactly where that cutting edge is.
So here is the base of the dam. Here's the top of the dam. Here are the sides. Here is the water over here. The base is 60 meters. The top is 4.5 meters. The height is about 8 meters. The slopes are about 3 to 1. Now, right now we're sitting on sand. So with the sand, it's essentially this layer here and then a chimney that runs all the way through the middle that we saw them digging over there. Dam width, you're always gonna have water coming through here. So water's gonna come through here, hit this center chimney here, permeate through the sand, go through this sand blanket that we're sitting on that sits on the base of the dam, hit a gravel channel at the end and drain. Right here, they had to build a keyway. So all of this is stripped from the topsoil and they just build on top of the topsoil. Whereas this right here was dug down, I think 2 meters, recompacted back up. And then now they're building their dam on top of that keyway that they've excavated there.
On top of the D9 pushing scrapers, that D9 has GPS. He knows where he needs to be pushing those scrapers to get grade. There's also Hitachi 670 excavator loading Bell articulated trucks. The scrapers are hauling to where we're standing right now. The trucks are hauling down there to the very base of the next section of dam. So they're working their way down. Over there is finished dam. Here is about midway height dam. Over there is dam that's just about a meter high, just getting off the surface. And then ahead of that is where they're prepping to start placing material in the first place. So it's just like an assembly line. They're sections and they work their way around in an orderly fashion all the way around to build that structure across that entire essentially circle. We're standing right here on top of the wall. This is the fill area. This is where the scrapers, the 631s and that MTS MT42 are coming in here and filling. There's a D6 working this area. He's pushing the material to level it out, running GPS so he knows the elevation, and he's ripping it to stir it up for then this water truck to come through and spray water through here to moisture condition the material. The moisture conditioning does two things. It helps with compaction and it helps this clay material expand. They do have a compactor working another area,
But just the weight alone of the scrapers and the machines, the water cart, the dozer coming through here gets this to just about the right compaction. You can see the material very high in clay. Based on how much it sticks to your boots when it's wet. So that's the fill area. This is the real money. This is building the actual structure. This will go all the way around. So thank you to MC Earthmoving for having us out. Hopefully you learned something, learned how to build a surge reservoir in case you need to go build your own surge reservoir. Only helpful content and tips here at BuildWit. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one. Stay dirty.